This is Unsane 21 giving you another recording right now, and this is I'm sorry about that. This is about one of the matchups that we have here in Summoner's Code, and sorry about that. This is for the interruption there. And first off, we have the blue side. We have this Spear, Casper, Metal Man, Scent, and Frappuccino Light. And on the purple side, we have Spaghetti, Moctis, Kylan, Tondo Killer, Jet Rising, and Patty Bear. And all of them right now, we are not facing this draft. They're all good players. And hope that you will be able to get at least a good time getting this recording. So, first ban for the red side here, for the blue side, they ban LeBlanc. They ban Lucian and they ban Zed. Lucian is Patty Bear's favorite champion. And for the purple side, we have the red side, we have the bans for Riven, Ryoma, and Syndra. And this is something a bit surprising here as well, because Ryoma is a very good champion and nobody wants to play with Ryoma. The hitbox for Ryoma is actually pretty good right now, and it the Xenoblade hits anything. Almost. It's like it fits almost on the spot when you try to dodge it. So sidestepping is harder with Ryoma against Ryoma. So who knows? It's and Ryoma's a bit tanky as well. So yeah, pretty much it. Now the first pick right now for the blue team is the Blitzcrank. This rank is good for the late game, especially when you're trying to look for a pick. This is this rank is actually not good in the mid game, but mid game because if you guys are behind, this rank is a bad champion to pick. Seriously, it's like pulling a carry can cause you death unless you're able to put all your crowd control. It all depends on what follows up after the Blitzcrank's pull. And right now, they are trying to hover on Janna, which is a good counter against a Blitzcrank. And also, another good counter for a Blitzcrank is a Lee Sin, if they get the Lee Sin. So Spaghetti actually goes for a Irelia jungle. Casper is looking for Hello. Alright, so we still have time. There's no rush right now looking for the right picks. But getting a Ryze for the top lane is a good idea, but getting a Diana. I don't see anything that will resemble a good team for the blue side if we choose the Diana. So they go for a Skarner instead. Alright, I've been seeing a lot of Skarners lately, and maybe because of that slight buff, but who knows. I mean, Skarner is actually quite a good champion, but not as good. Remember, I really hate the fact that you have to walk all the way into the tower just to get the ultimate. It's like walking towards somebody just to get the crowd control, and that's your ultimate. If you're brown, that's okay, because you really need to walk it, and that's only one of those few skills. But with Skarner, it's just that you really need to go near and try to pull someone. And with this, they have already a Janna pick, and it can just get worse right now. The pick right now for the purple side right now is a brand against, okay, so this is going to be one of those picks that is maybe why the grand, okay, so if you do the combo on the jungler and you guys the bank, you can get a good amount of the 2 second stun onto the target. So it's a very, Grand has one of the most powerful stun, and not an AoE stun, it's just a stun, it's a target stun, but it's just hard to pull off. So if you're able to pull off your stun, you can get the combos right, you can actually get the kill. Pretty decent play here for Brahmin, for Grand as well. And if they pick the 14, they have a very much a perfect AoE composition champ lineup, as well as the rest of the things that we've been doing here as well. So Paragon is just waiting. They're just waiting for the right champion right now, and I know Paragon is quite a good Raven. And there we go, Raven against a Vayne. It all depends. If Raven gets his power spike up before Vayne does, Vayne will have enough. Will be in trouble because Draven can actually tap a wall up every time it attacks. However, if Draven can actually get enough protection, but I believe Janna can provide enough protection for Draven. He has the Howling Gale, he has the Monsoon to protect him. So, in other words, it's a lot better for the purple side team here. The blue side team is more of a pick composition right now because of the disconnect, because of the Skarner pick. So it's going to be really tough getting away from them. So it's all about positioning, it's all about the right timing, the right people to stun, the right people to use the ultimate on. So once again, guys, so this is going to be a very, very good game, and we'll be right back after a couple of messages from our sponsors that doesn't exist. Alright, so sorry guys, I have to keep you waiting there, and welcome to Summoner's Rift. And here we are recording right now one of the second matches that I have in the screen right now for Summoner's Gold. That is this, if you want to join in one of the streams, you just stay up late at night, and just look for Shy, Nito, or Jago. Their summoner names is SCB, I don't know, I forgot Nito's summoner's name, but they'll post it here once you see the videos anyway, so. Is there, as an administrator, I think that it's their responsibility to make sure that everybody gets tagged. So, whoa, they completely missed the people there. And right now, gets pulled, Paddy Bear gets a pull there, and the flash is burned by Paddy Bear, and he is going to die. If not, and then Paddy Bear is gone, given to Vayne for the first early kill for this. And wow, Paddy Bear gets first blood easy. By Vistra, and the cooldown right now is we're looking at the Vistra carry wave for the pool, and it missed, so they are going to get picked by the AoE by Brand, and it's not gonna look pretty for the blue side. Instead, the early first blood, the early advantage right now goes completely towards the blue side team. And let me just make sure that I'm not too noisy right now. It's already late time. So they're going to try to steal the blue, and the red side will respond for a blue kill as well. And the Vayne will not be going home for an early advantage for the for his skill. So Vayne is waiting right now. And there we go. So they're starting for the early blue buff. They're not going to go for the Krogs. They're just going to go for the blue. And right now, I'm sure that everything is working properly here. And here we go, so the early blue buff, Spaghetti is the jungler, and he's using the Aurelia jungle. Now, talking about the Aurelia jungle, it's actually pretty nice and good. He has a good amount of sustain as well because of the passive of the second skill. He has a good amount of that closer because of the blade surge, and he has a stun. Because you would come off the jungle with a quite a low health as well. So you bait surge towards an enemy. You use do the equilibrium. Use the passive, do true damage, and then you'll be able to deal tons of damage onto enemy. That's without laners helping you out dealing those. So yes, so Irelia is quite a good mid laner, but there's a huge but. The problem with Irelia jungle is that the clearing isn't as good. As you can see here, Skarner is way ahead right now when it comes to clearing his loot. And he would think, if you look right now, we just pay attention to the map. Is right now he thinks that he has the Irelia has the red buff already, but Irelia is just starting the red buff right now. And Bran is right now looking at it's widening the upper side brush for the Reaper. And right now Jax is a bit having a problem with Malphite. That's a given because there is a lot of minions that is causing damage as well. Right now he is being shoved all the way through, and there is a level gap right there. So it's always important to know that there is a gank right now coming from Melon Man, Skarner, and they are going to be able to kill this Malphite easy. Thunder Killer gets killed by Skarner. So it's not the it's right now, as you can see a while ago, I've been saying this, it's all about the positioning and the proper rotations. Right now, there's no rotations yet. It's more about the positioning. So the pull a while ago that happened for that happened to Draven was all about the proper position, and it was also a good positioning ability that was done by the blue side team, because it was unexpected. The Janna warded the Cry Bush at the bottom part of the lane. Didn't expect that they were already passing by, and it was already too late. Unless Draven actually burns the flash immediately, he will be caught. So, alright, so they are trying to go for a counter kill here, and looks to me that they will not be able to do so thanks to the tower. And looks, and here we go, and it's not a good idea going near the wall. Gets condemned by the Bane, one more auto attack, and here we go, 3-0 right now with the 1.2k gold lead right now that is going to the blue side. So right now, so if you look at right now at the bottom side, you can actually see the chat. And if you I will be doing that, since sometimes when you chat you swear a lot. Jesus Christ, kids are playing this game as well, guys, so please do not swear in your games. Swearing is a bad thing. So, right now, the blue side is having tons of problems right now. They don't know what to do. They don't know. Yeah, just kidding. The only way for them to be able to win this game is not to die anymore and just continue on farming. And the Janna is actually doing tons of damage right now. And nah, that's a good switch right now. Blitzcrank pulls the Bran, and here we go, blue side gets a kill again. Spear is hooking champions like it was like hooking up with a chick. It's hard, but he can do it without any problems. I wish I could actually do that. So with the huge amount of lead right now, 1.4k gold lead advantage right now, I believe it should be more because of the kills. However, it's because some of the lanes are still farming and not much they can actually do when it comes to getting kills. Oh, now ultimate right now from Malphite hits the Jax, and one more burns the flash, and there is no more mana, and Exet is going to be saved by the tower. And right now they're just waiting for the right time, and Jax is looking to get back to base and Vayne, and Blitzcrank is having the time of their lives. And there we go, and a possible stun right now from look at that stun, it's forever, like it's almost like 2 seconds. And right now Spaghetti gets caught right now. This is 1-on-1 against a Skarner, but
Mafia is there to slow him down, and it's not gonna matter. And Bomb is there as well. No ultimate available for Bran. If Bran had ultimate, he could have actually have gone and used the Pyroclast, which is the ultimate, I guess. So. And Spear is in trouble right now. He's in the wrong position, mispositioning right now from Blitzcrank, and he is dead. So that is unfortunate for Blitzcrank, but a good sign that the Red Team will be able to actually make it through with this, because it's too early to say who's going to win, unlike the previous game that I casted a while ago. So if you watch it earlier, it's more about the positioning, and I told you guys, it's positioning is key, and especially in this upcoming patches, it's if you don't position properly, you can't get kills, you can't get in, you can't get hooked up to the girls, because you're not positioned properly and you're not gonna get laid. Because you're in the wrong position, if you get what I mean. So baby warding. One of the key elements, by the way, of the game is actually dewarding. So when you place a ward, you have to deward as well, so you can actually remove the opponent's ward and gain control of an area. In short, if you ward and deward, you can actually either one, get proper position, two, you can rotate easily because you will know where the champions are coming from, where you can actually move in order to get the proper positioning and advantages, so that you will have more information around the area of the map. So far it's more of, alright, so the Jax is hitting him, and right now he should have used the ultimate earlier, because right now Malphite is just running away and he's using the potions and ultimate by Malphite, and game over. And that was a return kill from the Malphite, and Malphite is actually pretty good in the mid game against the Jax, because if Malphite gets enough armor, like a Thorn Maid, and here we go. So right now Skarner is going to try to get the ultimate, and here we go, Bronze ultimate is splashing away, and that's half the HP right now done to Skarner and into the, oh my, it's not gonna work. So stuns the Blitzcrack. Nothing else that he can do right now. He did all that he can do. So let's just go back to the itemization right now. Why did the Brand did not do enough damage? It's because he was focusing right now on getting the mana regeneration. And there we go. I believe Jax is right now all the way behind. Alright, so if you're experiencing some lag, it's because I'm trying to render this game as well, because it's being recorded, as well as I'm actually recording the previous match as well, so it's just taking its time, and I do have to apologize for the inconvenience for people there, but don't you worry, everything is okay, and as long as you can actually get the play-by-play, that's fine. So, alright, so we're going back here, and Malphite is actually getting, must continue harassing the Jax. One is because Jax is a late game monster. So if you do not hit the Jax early on, make sure that he doesn't get enough farm. He will keep hitting you until you are at a disadvantage. So right now the blue side team is trying to get advantage for the dragon, their first dragon buff of the game, and that's an 86% attack boost. Right now Blitzcrank almost gets the pull right there. Unfortunately for Blitzcrank, Bran uses his splash, which is a good thing as well, and there's like three of them. Bran uses ultimate, but no damage done whatsoever, and this is a bad thing right now for Bran, and he gets condemned to the wall. No damage done for Skarner. Why are they focusing the Skarner? I don't understand why, but the Skarner will be happy to die for the team, getting two kills for the team right now, and as Raven is going to use his ultimate right now to do tons of damage. This moment of his crack, and it's not gonna be going pretty there. Flashes away all over the wall, and then the Draven will be just doing the shuffle moves, and one more auto attack, I guess, and then double kill for Vayne, and that's the game, ladies and gentlemen, there, and that was a pretty play from the blue side team. They were able to accomplish all of the things that they need. They were able to get the dragon. They were able to get all of the things done. I guess the reason why the red side, once they saw, I think the key ingredient here is that Brad should have understood that once he did this ultimate and the damage did not put them at least like 1/2 life remaining, or it was just simply half of the HP. It was just enough where I believe if your attack, if you have half HP, that's enough for you to be able to get to fight back against an enemy. So, one, if you burn your flash, try to escape, never come back unless you have enough backup to do so. Secondly, you already blew your ultimate, so probably the giant blew his Howling Gale ultimate. The enemy team has already tried to kill them, and right now he's gonna be dying again. And this is a complete map. This is a complete wash up right now, and Grant can't do nothing against the bottom lane right now because his damage is not as good yet. Probably if he gets something like, does the Skarner have an ultimate and follow up with the stun? Uses the unstoppable force to get away from the certain death that is about to happen to him, and right now that's the Skarner just taxing the top lane, and here we go, this is in the tribush, but Blade Surge is into the Skarner. Skarner doesn't have the ultimate, why are they not trying to fight back? Of course they are not going to try to fight back because they are missing the Blitzcrack, and the Diana was going to the top lane. As you can see a while ago, there is enough water to give them enough information here, and if you look here right now, Draven can actually pull off one kill, and he misses the ultimate right now, and Janna gets a vain kill and Draven doesn't get any kill. That is a very unfortunate thing that happened to Draven. They got Draven out. So the story right now, Draven is 0-5-1, and the rest of the team has one kill on its belt, and that's not a good sign of a team fight. So Draven is actually carrying the game right now, getting his power spike right now. He has a Blade of Proven King, but right now going for a static shiv and setting it up for probably another power item, which we will be seeing later. I guess he already bought the item, so this is going to be fun for Blitzcrank, and is Blitzcrank going to die? I don't know, but let's see here, there is no follow-up in the map there. So it is best for them not to back up, but for the red team to back up from that particular scenario. Unfortunately, if they tried to follow their guts, I guess they could have actually just do it a while ago, so it was reversed. And right now, there was from the upper riverside is no longer there, has expired, but they have warded the dragon area to make sure that they have enough visibility. There is also one deep ward on the red side of the red team, and was likely like slightly offensive ward on the red side, as well as the blue the bunch of defensive wards on the red side as well for the red team. So Vayne right now is turning into a late game monster. 7-1-2, that's the score, and the story right now here is positioning and how to become a good AD carry. And so far Vayne is a harder champion to play. I have to give respect right now to Patrick Vayne in playing that champion, because Draven is hard to play. I tried my best, and Unstoppable Force was used, and it's not enough to escape Stasper and Sand, because that is a very far away Unstoppable Force. It was from here all the way to there, but still Stasper and Xen did their combos, and it wasn't enough. Right now, Irelia is actually doing numbers onto them. Vayne is actually doing tons of damage right now, and Brad is going to kill Vayne and follows up with the Brad gets the Q the skill sets. So it is it's a good sign right now. This is a sign that the red team is actually doing something about the name dying. It is more of making sure that they get the kills. So right now the dragon's up and they are all alive, no junglers available. If the jungler is on the red side area of the red team. So it can actually try to do this as fast as possible. However, the jungler is still far away right now from the blue side and the red side as well. So they are able to get the red team is able to get their first dragon buff, which is 6%. 6% damage for AP and attack damage, so they're quite even right now when it comes to that. But gold experience leveled up the levels. Let's see the levels here. They're slightly the blue team is actually slightly ahead in the experience department. So right now, because the blue team is not able to get the dragon buff, they're just going to push the middle lane and they're going to safely back off. And right now Vayne is actually in a position right now being warned by his teammates not to stay in that particular area, and they're right now warding and making sure that no one is there. And the red team right now suspects that they are just waiting right now in the red buff area right now and see what they can actually do. Right now Blitzcrank is actually waiting for a good pull right now. Which champion can he pull? What Pokemon can he hit? And he doesn't hit it with the Master Ball. And so far I think he just used an ordinary Pokeball, that's why it missed. And right now it is not looking good right now for the red side team. They're being pushed to the limits right now. They do have a Malphite right now, but it will not be enough. Pulse the Janna and the Brand is the ultimate, doing tons of damage on Frappuccino right now. GDSF kills the Brand. Thunder Killer actually gets two for the bottom lane duo is killed in the area right now. So that's the area I saw a while ago. Right now being chased by a three champions with a Janna, so that is a very risky thing. However, they will be making it onto the air onto the so they are alive. So that was for a 2-for-2 things to go Malphite's bravery. And once again I would like to say this again. So it was a messy clash, so to speak, and the Vayne expected that the Malphite will die soon enough. However, if you look at the itemization of the Malphite, Frozen Heart is actually pretty good as well against a Vayne, because it slows down the attack speed by up to 25% as long as you're within the area of the Frozen Heart. Oh my god, they just stole the blue buff from Brand. So why? Alright, so Get Rising right now is absolutely pissed right now. And alright, so Blitzcrank here, and he's trying to try to do something right now, and misses the hook shot. And that's a dead Janna right there. And right now, Blitzcrank is just waiting for his opportunity right now, and hits the uppercut. Brand gets the ultimate down, and Skarner is stacking tons of damage right now, and Raven is actually killing people right here, and kills the Blitzcrank with the ultimate. So it might see here a turnaround. So here we go. The only thing that they need to do right now is we need to push the middle lane and see what they can actually do. Brad can actually do a ton of AOE damage, so to speak. So if he keeps it up, he can actually clear the waves and stuff like that. So alright, so that was a very intense matchup. And right now, Janna is actually, what he's doing right now is freezing the lane, making sure that there will be no damage done to the inner turret in the bottom lane, which is a good idea because supports That's what we do. Blitzcrank is actually trying to get the kill right now on to Malphite, and okay, tries to clear them ward, but not enough attack speed and movement speed as well here, and he might be trying to make a pull here, and he could have just tried to getting a pull. However, the Brad is actually getting enough AP. You see there, that's a lot of AP already there. So alright, so right now the blue team strategy is still in the blue buff right now, red buff, and Brad throws in the ultimate and hits a lot of people right now. Starter dies, Janet is alright, so the Vayne is actually doing a ton of damage right now. The blue team's Jax is actually doing lots of work right now, and it's because it's already 23 minutes. The Jax Jax would be having almost like the Blade of the Ruined King, and oh my goodness, the Diana is actually manlier than the Jax there. He dives in with the ultimate and with the Q, so that is the Raven ultimate there as well. Brad is going to throw the okay, it hits the child. Let me just make sure that the sphere, the Riot understands that if you get hit onto the last part of your teleport back home, you're clear to go back as long as one, you're not dead. If you like get hit, but let's say on the 0.5 seconds that you get hit, you can actually still go back home. But if you get hit and it is enough to kill you, then that's about it. So alright, so here we go, Cornemo, Janna, and the ultimate by Skarner, and that's a ton of damage dealt on to that poor support. So right now we have a 10,000 gold lead advantage right now favoring the blue side, and because they already pushed all the towers, they already pushed killed more champions, like 10 more champions or 11 more champions, so to speak, and 10,000 gold is completely nothing. I mean, it's already almost late game right now. They have a Jax, you can actually kill them all, and see here. They're actually looking for the Vayne right now. The Vayne is in trouble. Alright, so right now what they're trying to do right now is to get the Vayne and intentionally try to make sure that they will be able to try to push the bottom lane towers as well here. And the ward coverage is enough to make sure that it will be possible to push the bottom lane. And Vayne is actually the one trying to make sure that the minions are being pushed. That's a good ward by Janna. Unfortunately, one of them will be dying here. And who is it going to be? I have no idea. That was a good pull, but it's not long enough because of the leech nerf onto the Blitzcrank. So they decide not to actually go pushing the mid lane. However, most of them actually went back and they will be buying items here. So the Vayne has an IE, a Blade of the Ruined King, and an almost static shield that might turn into a Phantom Dancer. So very confusing, but effective. So right now, here's the magnificent positioning that they are doing right now. As you can see, right now they're trying to look for the best position right now. One of them is in the bar, but doesn't get hit by either Hook or the ultimate by Diana. So Diana gets the blue buff, which is actually a good idea because he is the AD. She is the AD, right? Sorry about that, ladies. So right now, Dragon will be up in the next 2 minutes right now, and they are trying to look for a pick. Any champion would do. That's a good flash, but... he's going to put the area there, and... gonna get hit by the Howling Wave and the Monsoon. I don't know which one's the worst one, because right now, they just made the area blue splash and blue the Dragon Ultimate as well. Good stuff from the blue team there. So right now, this is more of a stalemate, ladies and gentlemen, and it's, we're just going to keep it quiet right now because I would need to listen to what they're going to try to do. And right now, the Vayne is pushing, split pushing into the bottom lane right there, and right now, Malphite is hitting them with their ultimate right now. Braun is actually hitting all of them with the ultimate, and Diana is about to die, and Jax is doing tons of damage onto them. DPS, they're one down. He gets a Draven. And I think this is a game there. And the Jax and the Skarner did all the damage they can do. And it could be game over here. So that's a quick GG. So thank you so much for watching here. I do hope that you enjoy this game right now. If you were to ask me right now who is the MVP of this match, it has to be the Vayne, which is Frappuccino Light. So thank you so much for the KDA R5. He has been doing all of the things that he can do, lane management at the bottom lane, and trying to get all of the turnaround kills as well. So, and who is the downside on the other side of the other team? It will be the Draven, because he has the most deaths. It wasn't fully protected. He was getting pulled left and right, misposition, he was being out of place, probably lack of communication on his teammates' part as well. So thank you so much for watching the shoutcast of this match. I do hope that you were able to sign up for one of our tournaments at this upcoming January 30, 2014. And if you would like to join I think registration is already over, but you might be able to still catch up. So look for Shy, look for Nico, or look for Jago. So once again, this is Unsane21 signing out.